we haven't been to Christchurch for like 2 years. As soon as we heard that it was going, you know, like some people were like, oh, that's such a long way, it costs so much money to get down there, but you know, like when you do it, it's bloody worth it. I love it, like that's, it's well worth the trip, it's well worth, you know, it's the hardest trip to do, you know, no matter how you do it, but it's well worth it. You get there, you have so much fun, so many corners, the section's so long, you learn so much, you know, like if we had a track like that in Northland, like, I think our drivers would be even better. I'd just come in and you'd come into the pits and Mike T's going and like, you know, and I'm like, yeah, this is cool, and your tires all wobble, wobble, wobble. You're like wobbling in the bum and tires all out of shape because you just want to try and get as many laps in as possible, you know, and it's yeah, real cool. We sold some hot laps to fundraise some money to get to Christchurch, being the, you know, the most expensive round of the year. Yeah, so had a bit of fun taking people for rides, and they were just buzzing out. Like, they come from all over the place, you know, just to come for a ride, and you know, paid good money, and thanks a lot to those people that did that, you know, to help us out. Like, they got the best ride out of everyone, you know, like, because it's such a long track, and you know, if we're going to go out there, we're going to bust the whole session and blow some tires. So I think one of the passengers I came through, I was just having so much fun, and I think I plucked forth a couple of times on the last corner just to let it really have it, and yeah, we came in and we were bouncing up and down because the tires were out of shape and stuff, so it was quite good. When these people like are paying for a hot lap, you know, they're pretty much, you know, we're blowing $500 worth of tyres and, you know, 20 litres of gas a session, and yeah, it's pretty, I'd say it's money well worth it, you know, to buy a hot lap and go and have the experience. I just like a Sunday drive, you know, take someone for a drive and have a laugh, and out you sleep, give them the thumbs up, and they're like, yeah, and you're just like, you're shit skiing, eh? Or whether it's even at Pookie, so.
Yeah.
But I hope so. Love the speed, eh?
Sick. Cheers for that, mate.
Hot lap. Yeah. Oh. Great.
Yeah, bro.
know, we had our first battle with Kyle Jackways, and he was driving, he had to borrow a car because something had gone wrong with his, and he'd come around for our chase, and I was like, oh, you see, I'll be out, you know, you got a little bit of a leeway with the V8 and that. And we come into the first corner, and I was like, oh my God, you know, like, just come in, gave him a hit. I was like, man, you know, I didn't think you could go around that corner that slow without keep drifting, you know, and I was like, whoa. I was pretty lucky to actually go ahead and beat him, you know, because, you know, you go against, like, that's just mostly how that car goes. It most had no grip going into the first corner. And, you know, trying to slow a big car down like this, like, I don't really realise, like, I take people for rides, like other drivers in my car, and they can't believe how fast I can go into a corner and slow that car down. It's something that I actually want to do more of, driving with slower cars. Like, I'm not getting any better driving against a fast car. You know, you're just in for the ride. When you're chasing a fast car, you're just like trying to, you know, keep a good line.
And Phil Sutherland hasn't been seen in D1NZ so far this season. Fanga Dan can't afford to take any battle lightly.
What about some of these unknown South Island boys that you guys haven't seen before? How do you deal with chasing them?
You know, if they're a bit out of shape in front of you, you can just sort of glide back, a bit more handbrake, a bit more clutching, and, you know, but you can let the revs die down so much on these things and play with them no matter what the battle throws in front of you.
So you see there, Phil Sutherland has the lead as the higher qualifier, absolutely smashing the throttle of the 2JZ through the last big sweeping corner there. Fanga Dan perhaps a little bit further back than he would have.
It was a bit, you know, disappointing to go up, you know, in my second battle against one of the South Islander drivers. Car that, you know, heaps of power and heaps of grip. Like, you know, like I couldn't believe how fast he pulled away from me. Like, he was same thing again. Like, he'd come into the first corner and he was just like super slow going into the first corner. I was like, just about took him out, because I was like, you know, I didn't think you'd go around that corner that bloody slow, you know, but then just pull away from me, like, just, you know, not as much angle and stuff like that. And it was like, I just sat back. I was just like, well, you know, I just started laying on the angle and just, you know, just drifting back. And he pulled, like, you know, three car lengths on me before the end of the section.
Yeah, from Phil though. Yeah, Phil Sutherland was off the line there that the judges were looking for, but he's created a massive gap there over Fanga Dan Woolhouse. And Fanga Dan, if anything, is falling back even further. So Phil Sutherland is going to take a big advantage out of this first run of the one more time battle. Fanga Dan could be going home in the top 16, and that will have massive implications for this title fight, as we see Fanga Dan now taking his lead run. And look at Filthy Phil all over the rear of the Castrol Edge Commodore.
That's an epic chase there from the A31 as we switch into the turn three. Is he going to be able to close the gap? He pushes wide.
Yeah, it was a bit gutting. Like, you know, I was a bit disappointed, especially, you know, like, I wouldn't want to go out there and, you know, heaps of angle and then have a car beat me that's low angle and, you know, and just pulled away from me, you know. But hey, you know, there's another thing as well, you know, like, if you want to be the best at, if you want to be like the drift king or whatever, you know, like what we're trying to achieve, then you gotta beat whoever gets thrown in front of you too, you know, like that's you know, like that's gotta happen. But we move on, man, you know, like we walked away, we were happy, you know, we're still got points. And yeah, move on, you know, move on to the finals. Just so pumped for the finals at Taupo. It's, yeah, like I wish it was months ago, and I've just been hanging out. I, you know, we did a bit of a practice down there at D-Comp last weekend, just to go and have a feel and go back and balance, you know, try and battle all different types of cars. Hey, you know, we just got to go there, we got to make sure the cars, we're just going to go over it with a fine tooth comb and check everything over and do some little changes that we want to do to it. Just in the real life, we're not going to try and make it faster or more power or anything stupid like that, you know, we just want to make sure that it's going to finish. Don't want to let myself down and don't want to let my fans down and stuff like that, and I don't want to let the car down too, you know, like the I think the car deserves it, you know, I think the team deserves it. So we got a few you know, plans for the finals, just to everyone's got their own job and it should be like that, and it is, but I think we really want to just relax everyone. I want everyone to be relaxed, and I want everyone to have their own little jobs, and I think if we all do that, and I think the team will pull it off, hopefully. So that's the plan, but hey, as long as we're having fun, man, and that car drives on the trailer at the end of the day, I'm stoked.